Hello everyone, this is Ask Muhammad Khan and I welcome you and congratulate you that you have come in new class, in 8th class student. And I will teach you science and from today we are starting a new chapter, crop production and management. Yes student, crop production and management. In our daily life, we need the three different things like air, water and food. These are our basic requirement, air, water and food. And food provide us energy and it also help us in our growth and it also protect our body from the diseases. Now student, from where we get the food? Food we get from the plants and animals. But from where the plants and animal get, student? They get from the sun and with the help of the earth. Our earth is the only planet that supports us in our life. All the life supporting activities are possible only on the earth, student. Only on this planet. And today is the World Earth Day. So I again congratulate you or say you happy World Earth Day. And we can protect it with the help of green revolution by growing more and more crops in our fields. With the help of that, we will get the food and we will also help to our environment, because the plants or the forest, what they do, they purify and clean the environment, student, and they also provide us food. So for getting the food, what we need the crop production. And this crop production occupation or the agriculture occupation is the oldest occupation, student, because it is directly related to our food, student. Without agriculture or without farming, we can't get the food. Can we get? No. In a proper amount, we will not get. The credit that goes for the green revolution or for the more and more crop production is given to our great PM Lal Bahadur Shastri, who started the green revolution. And in behind of it, there was a son scientist, and the name of that scientist was K. Swaminathan. So you will learn the name of these great personalities. Now we come on the crop production, student. What is the main source of energy? It is sun. From the sun, the plants get the sunlight and they do one important process, student. It is known as photosynthesis. With the help of photosynthesis, plants make their own food. And by making their food, we get that food in our diet. Like, first the sunlight is falling on the plants and plants are making their food with the help of one important process that is known as photosynthesis, and from the plants we are getting the food. Or from the plants, other animals are getting the food, especially the herbivores. Or indirectly, all the animals are dependent on the plants only, because the carnivores eat the herbivores and herbivores eat the plant, student. So we can say that the plants are the living organism from which we get the more and more food. Now, the practice from which we can grow or cultivate the food or the crop, that practice is known as agricultural practice. And the branch of science that deals with the study of the crop production and management is known as agriculture. Student, you will learn it, agriculture. And the person who do the agriculture are known as, yes student, are known as farmers. So farmers are the most important creature on our noble earth that are providing us food, student, because they manage the crop and they grow the crops. For this they do the hard work, and by doing their hard work we are getting the food in our plates, student. In our plates we are getting the food. So we should always show our full respect to the farmers. Now we come on the crop. Now what is crop, student? You will learn it and try to write this definition in your notebook. What is crop? When the same kind of plants are grown in a particular area, that are known as crop, student. Means when the same kind of plants are grown and cultivated in a particular area, that particular plants are known as crops. And the area where are the plants are cultivated, that particular area is known as field, student. Now we come on the types of crop. There are three types of crop, student: Kharif crops, Rabi crops, and Zaid crops. These are the three types of crops. Now, the Kharif crops, the crop that is grown in between June to September is known as Kharif crop, and it is also known as rainy season crop. And the example of these crops are rice and maize. Now we come on the next. Rabi crops. The crop that is grown and cultivated in between October to March, in between October to March, is known as Rabi crop. And these crops are also known as winter season crop, student. And the wheat and pea and the gram, these are the example of the Rabi crops. In nowadays the harvesting is going on, and which crop harvesting is going on, student? Tell me. It is wheat. And wheat comes in which category, student? It comes in the category of Rabi crop. Now we come on the next, third type of crop that is not given in your book, but you will try to learn it. It is Zaid crop, student. Zaid crop. And it is the crop that is grown in between March to June. In between March to June. And generally, they are known as summer season crop. Summer season crops. And in these crops, the crops that comes are melon, watermelon, gourd, cucumber. They come in the category of Zaid crop. So it is about the crop, student. Now in our next segment, we will learn about the agricultural practice, that how do the farmer grow the crops. Thank you very much and have a pleasant day.